Hello, my name is Firsh. I'm the creator of Justified Image Grid. I'm going to show you the plugin settings, the shortcode editor, and the connection between them. We'll create some galleries too. Open your dashboard, find the Settings tab, and click Justified Image Grid. This is the global plugin settings that apply for each and every gallery on your site. There are preset buttons at the top. Clicking them will update every option to the preset's own values, that's all they do. If you play with the values below, they won't change the actual preset. You only use them as an origin point. The options are split into tabs. If you want your galleries to look the same, use these settings instead of shortcode attributes. They are created by the shortcode editor. To use that, you need to have TinyMCE, the visual editor, enabled. Go to Users, your profile. Make sure you uncheck Disable the visual editor when writing. Create a page or a post. Pages, Add New. Enter a title. On the Visual tab, find the purple shortcode editor button and click it. The settings available here will only be used by this particular gallery. They will overwrite the global settings that are marked as default all over the place. For example, when you select a preset here, the global settings will no longer apply. Click Create Shortcode, then copy from the field on the right. Paste into the content of your page or post. Click Publish. If you check out your page now, you will see a notice that is normal. Post doesn't have any attached images yet. Click on Add Media. Switch the drop-down list from all media items to upload it to this page. Select some files. You can also drag and drop them. And click Open. I am currently showing you the original method this plugin used in previous versions of WordPress. You can use it if you like, as it's somewhat easier than the new way. If you refresh the tab, the gallery will appear because it has photos now. You can reorder the photos here and it will update the gallery on the page. When you're done, do not insert them into the post. Just close this. To change, click Add Media again. Make sure it's in Upload it to this page mode and reorder the images. Click Upload Files and add more photos to the page. Wait for them to finish uploading. Then go to the page. If you refresh the tab, you will see the changed order and the new photo. The other way was introduced with WordPress 3.5 and is more versatile but takes longer. The benefit is that you can choose any picture from the media library. Click Add Media, then click Create Gallery. Select photos from the media library or upload new ones. Click Create a new gallery. You can establish a custom order. Once done, click Insert Gallery. If you publish the page now, you will see a WordPress gallery as usual. Switch to Text Editor. Then duplicate the gallery shortcode. On the first line, change the word gallery to Justified Image Grid. Use underscores instead of spaces. The important part is the IDs attribute. My plugin should be above the WordPress gallery shortcode in order to hide it. Click Update. You will see that my plugin replaced the WordPress gallery. You're done. I'm going to show you how to edit the gallery. Go to the Visual Editor. Keeping the blue gallery block is optional, but it's nice to be able to visually edit the gallery later. Click on the left button to edit it. Reorder, add, or delete images. Then click Update Gallery. Switch to the text editor. You will need to copy the updated IDs attribute into Justified Image Grid. Update and you're done. Here is how you can edit the shortcode. Go to the visual editor. Select. Copy. Open the shortcode editor. Paste the shortcode at the top. The settings from the shortcode are automatically loaded into the editor. You can see the IDs field is already populated. You can conveniently make changes or add new options attributes in this window. For example, choose a preset. Click Create Shortcode. Copy. Then replace the old one in your page. Update. Look at the page. The images are now shown with your chosen preset. Stay tuned for more episodes where I dig deeper into customization. I'll show you other image sources like NextGen Gallery, Facebook, and Flickr. Thank you for watching this. I'll see you next time.